In business, you're working day to day on stuff, and sometimes when someone shows up a shiny new object, it's kind of like, don't show me the shiny object, I have to work. So when something like a big business wants to roll out Office 365, sometimes people don't want to learn about it, or they don't have time right now. And so we've debuted two features today that we can show you that give materials to folks, either employees or those IT pro people that are trying to roll out the materials to help get Office 365 up and running. Office 365 can be rolled out very quickly. A lot of times with big business, so we're talking thousands of employees, a lot of times there's what's called an adoption plan to get it up and running. We're going to show you both materials for you today that you can start sharing that are new today at Office. There are several versions of Office for business. We've talked about small business before. Today we're really going to concentrate on the mid-sized business, which is 26 to 300 folks, or what's called enterprise. No one's been able to tell me why it's called enterprise instead of big business, but we'll think of it as big business. This is for an unlimited. This is for hundreds or thousands of folks that you want to roll out for office.com. Now, with Office 365, we talk a lot about the cloud, about using different devices and different places of collaborating. But know this, if you get what's called this final plan here, which is Office 365 Enterprise E3, it's a monthly subscription for $20 a month per user. And each user gets the full version of Office downloaded to the computer. So if it's a PC, you get Word 2013, Excel 2013, Outlook 2013, you get the idea. There's a ton of other things that you can also get with Office 365, but each employee can put that up onto five devices, including we have Office for Android and iPhones now that you can use. So there's a lot there, but again, I want to make sure everyone knows that they get the full version of Office with that. Again, we can talk about that more. Also, if you're on the U.S. site and you go to this page, you might find a chat now button. That connects you to folks if you have questions about how something works, or if you're interested about some more sales information. And there's a lot more here, but I want to talk about those new areas that just debuted today. One of those areas is the Office 365 for Business Learning Center. That's at office.com/learnoffice365. This is all the materials that we have, or the best materials we have, for Office 365 for Business. Now, all this is available on Office. You've been able to search for it, but we've kind of indexed and put it all in one place for you. So at the top of the screen, if you're, again, trying to introduce yourself to what Office 365 is, you're trying to install it on your PC or your Mac, or setting up Link. All those materials are right there at the top, just a click away, and you can go there. So let's go to the setup Link page here. And again, this is office.com/learnoffice365. And here you get some instructions. There's a minute and 40 video here. Again, just going over some of the basic tasks and getting all the information to you about those materials. Let me go back and drill into another area here. So let's look at, oh, by the way, I should point out for this, if there's anything here you'd like to see that you're not seeing or have any information for us about this learning center, at the bottom right-hand corner, that's our feedback. Just let us know, and we'll look at those questions. And again, not an area to get Q&A to get the answers to you, but if there's something you're looking for, we're happy if you can send us some feedback. We'd love to have it. Let's go into documents. Again, there's a lot of areas where sharing documents happen. In Office 365, not only can you talk to folks through Link, which is kind of what I call IM on steroids, you can actually talk to folks and work with folks while you're in the document, which is kind of a new feature for a lot of folks. So we have a whole area about sharing team documents. So you can, again, we have articles, we have videos. This one here, video share documents, is, I'm not going to play the video here, but it's a minute and 9 seconds long. So it gets you some great information very quickly about dealing with how you share documents. Also, right below these icons, there are quick start guides. Let's do the one for SkyDrive Pro. In fact, let me talk about SkyDrive Pro really quickly. Anyone can get SkyDrive. Just go to skydrive.com, sign in if you have a Microsoft ID or a Hotmail account. You already have an account there. You can get up to 7 gigabytes of storage and store all your documents, just not Office documents. When you Office 365 for Business, you get SkyDrive Pro. It is kind of the same thing. You get to store documents that are behind what we call the firewall for business, but you can send links out to folks. So instead of sending an email with an attachment, you can send a link out to a document either in to people inside your company or outside your company, that people can either edit that document or just view the document. And you can store it on SkyDrive Pro, and that way you can get to that document anywhere you can sign in to your business account with Office 365. So this Quick Start Guide, you'll find Quick Start Guides several places at office.com. This is a, again, you know, when you get a big, like, I don't know, you buy a dishwasher, you get the big manual, you don't want to read the manual. You just read that little two-page guide that shows you how to quickly start the dishwasher. That's what Quick Start Guides are. So here are just basic information about how to share a document. It's, I think, 6 pages, so it's easily printable, or if you just want to use it online. But those are Quick Start Guides that are available. And again, anything here in the Business Learning Center is available for anyone. So if this interests you, even if you're not in the IT Pro or you have Office 365, maybe not the business version, many of these materials will work for you. SkyDrive Pro won't, but things like sharing documents in Office 365. So that's some of the materials that you can find at the Business Learning Center that just debuted today, hours ago, at office.com/learnoffice365. The other thing I wanted to show is for the IT pro person. Quick thing about business, you want to be nice to three people every day. One is the business admin or the floor person who can get you paperclips or knows the invoice. You want to be nice to your copy editor if you do writing, and also the IT pro person, because not only can they control your computer, they get questions all day that are from technical people that really know what they're talking about to people who say, where's the power button? So they get a lot of odd questions. So you want to be really nice to them. So I'm talking to those folks now that help roll out IT, help roll out businesses. Again, you can roll out Office 365 relatively quickly, especially small business, but when you're dealing with large corporations, sometimes you need several weeks to adopt it for to get it set up the correct way, but also to train your employees that that shiny object's going to come up. We've put several materials here in this new Adoption 365 Adoption and Learning Kit area. You can download some materials that can help you do it. I'm going to open up one of them here, which is the getting on board with Office 365, kind of an overview document that shows you as you go through the different planning. Again, if you're in a small business or never done a large business, this is going to be foreign to you. But again, when you're dealing with thousands of people and thousands of people who maybe want to know information, this type of adoption is sometimes needed. So planning, awareness, learning, and then the readiness. Let me go over to a page I like here, which is kind of shows you what has to happen sometimes with big business. This is a sample campaign of a rollout that will take several weeks. So you get you up to speed yourself, the IT pro department, and then you roll that material out to the employees. And this comes with several things. One is a scenario spotlight. Let me open up one of these for SkyDrive Pro here. That's a page that, again, can be something sent an email, it can be made into a small poster, it can be sent out to folks that kind of show how SkyDrive Pro works in a couple easy steps, because that'll be something new for folks. I gotta say, I was in a business one time that SharePoint just showed up one day and there was no training on that. So stuff like this would have been really something that I would have needed in that other business that will remain nameless. Let's see what else we have here in this kit. We have posters and booklets. In fact, I printed one out here, so let's look at the one. So team sites, if your company's never done a SharePoint site or anything like that, sites are going to be something new. So if you're on video, you can see it, and you can also see it on the feed here. It's just a little two-page. You can print up to a large-size poster. It just kind of quickly goes through the UI. The back page just kind of goes through some basic information about that. So we have these for several different areas that are part of this adoption kit that IT pros can download. And let's see, one other thing I should show, posters and booklets. And again, just some awareness posters that you would stick, I don't know, by the elevator or whatever. And again, this is for big businesses that deal with a lot of information. Here's a poster you could post about that SkyDrive Pro is here, with a picture of the place I'm gonna work next. Look at that, hardwood floors, a big window. I think this might be the place I want to go. He said from the windowless room that he's in right now. Let's head back. So this is all found in the Adoption and Learning Kit Center inside Tech Center. Again, basically built for those IT pro people, the IT person in your office that works with these types of things. Since I have a little time, let me show really briefly some things about Office 365. I'm going to open up a account. Today I will be Alex Darrow. So this is, let me just show a couple pages here. This is Office 365. Office 365 may look different for you just because those IT pro people set them up. Different permissions, different features are turned on and off. So yours may not look the same as mine. Hopefully you don't have the picture of Alex Darrow because that's a, well, it's a real person, but I don't know who it is. It's definitely not me. But this is one way to look at SkyDrive Pro. So he has Alex, or I, Alex, have my documents here. I can get them if, again, I could sign into Office 365 in Florida or whatever and get to my documents this way. One of the things I love about this page is if you go here and click on these dots, you actually can preview the document even before you open it. It should open up in a web app here. And I can actually, before I even take time to open up the document, I can see if that's the document that I want to open, if that's the right one, is you try to figure out, okay, which document do I have? So you can drag documents into SkyDrive Pro this way. Let's go up to the upper right-hand corner and show you some other things. You do get, for Office 365 Business, the Enterprise E3 plan, you do get Outlook.com, but also for other SKUs, or you can also use it online. This is the Outlook web app. Looks very much like Outlook. But again, I could sign in to Office 365 from another computer and still get this web app that shows my reminders and shows my email, and also my calendar is here also. So that's part of Office 365. And then let's go over to Sites. Again, if you've never been to SharePoint, this is kind of the big business area that you can do individual sites for. Each team can have a site, each project could have a site, virtual teams could have a site, then that's where they keep their documents, their assets or whatever, that you could keep them in individual sites, and it's searchable within SharePoint and shareable, that you could do that. So sites could mean many things. Again, you can make your own on the fly. There's even public websites that you can use. And if I may click on that, you can just do a simple public website if you need to. So sites are internal and external for Office 365. So there's the bistro. We'll go there later for lunch today. So that's kind of a brief overview of Office 365 for Business. Again, the adoption and learning kit is available today at Office at the Tech Center. And for anyone at office.com is the Business Learning Center, and that's at office.com/learnoffice365. We'll have the links up for that at our website for this blog, for this webinar, aka.ms/biz365. We'll have the video up in a couple days, but we'll have the links to those new areas that you can go to at aka.ms/biz365. You can find more information about the Office webinar series at aka.ms/offweb. Next week, we'll be talking about Presentation View in PowerPoint. If you've presented with a PowerPoint and never used Presentation View, I'm going to rock your world next week. That's guaranteed. But for today's Office webinar team, thank you for joining this Office 15-minute webinar.